these actors. One of them is actually a black belt who could probably kick my backside, so I'm trying to do a really good introduction for him. So ladies and gentlemen, from Sword Art Online, you lose Kirito and you lose Eren Yeager at Attack on Titan. Please give it up for Bryce Kapper and Lucina. She plays Mikasa Akron in Attack on Titan. Give it up for Trina Nishimura!
Stay after the credits.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's I'm not saying anything else.
But isn't it nice though now, because in the last, it's only been happening in the last 12 or 18 months, we start to see not just that, but other anime films finally getting the recognition they deserve in big screen cinemas.
Yeah.
Do you think that trend can continue?
I hope so. It's a totally different experience watching something on a big screen with a crowd of people. I went to the North American premiere, and you know, there's moments where the crowd was laughing, where they were cheering, where, you know, there's sort of intimate moments between Yuito and Asuna, where everyone's like, aww, you know, you got all those little points of the film that the creators were shooting for to get a reaction from the crowd, and it was nice to sort of experience that with them. So it's really fun to see anime in the theaters, and yeah, I hope it's a trend. So go see Sword Art Online Ordinal Scale if you can get a ticket. Definitely see it.
Or the I don't know why I'm saying it.
I think also Attack on Titan has a couple of movies.
Oh my gosh! No, wait.
Can we say it?
Yeah. Oh, I don't know about that.
I think we can.
Are you sure?
I think I got an email saying you're allowed to talk about this.
Is anyone recording this?
Say it.
Look what you said. There's more going on right here.
So, if I'm not supposed to say this, I'm about to get sued. I'm pretty sure I can. So, we did a couple of recap movies for Attack on Titan that essentially sum up all of season one. And there's two films, and there's new footage in the films. Did you come back and record new stuff? I don't know if Mikasa had new scenes.
No. But, I'm really excited. I saw a little bit of it.
It's
awesome.
It's gonna be awesome. So if you can catch that in theaters, I don't know if it's coming to the UK. I hope it is. I saw there's gonna be a limited release in the US. But that's a great way to catch you all the way up to where season two will begin.
Yes.
And is it just one long jump screen?
It's two and a half hours of just
interspersed with the time.
Yeah.
It's like
so if you would like to ask our guest a question, now is your time to do so. We're going to start right over this side with this gentleman here. His hand shot up.
Yes.
A question for both of you, because both of you are in shows which are getting second series, Miraculous Ladybug and You're in Ice, with what's hopefully going to get a second series.
I'm sorry, what?
You're in Ice, because it's going to get a second
series.
Yes, I am. I thought you said you're an ass. I was like, oh. Like, Kat Kumar, you're an ass. Like, I mean, you're an ass. That was basically all of my college career.
Miraculous is coming out in June. So are we going to get any, like, is there any, like, little sneaky snore lines you can tell us? And the second part is, for you, what do you think we'll get to see in Your Own Eyes, and what would you like to see in the second series?
So, as far as season two of Miraculous, I know nothing about what's going to happen with the series. I wish they would tell me more, but they just don't. But we did record some webisodes that are, I think, coming out weekly. They might all be out already, and those are really cool. They're just little vignettes, so I definitely recommend checking those out to sort of hold you off for season two.
For season two, if you're an ass, it's the same. I don't know. They don't really tell us much about the second season in general. Usually you show up and they're like, this is what's happening, now go! So unfortunately, I don't know. But I look forward to season two of Yuri on Ice. Yeah. But thank you for the question. That was an excellent question.
And we have a question from our person here at the front.
Hello.
Hi.
What do you think of the shipping that happens between characters in Attack on Titan?
It's a really funny show to ship characters with, because it's so serious, and then to think that there's relationships happening in this world is just kind of funny. I mean, Eren seems to get shipped with Levi quite a bit.
A lot. All the time. People are like, hey, Bryce, what do you think of Eren x Levi? And he's like, I think I've heard that a lot.
I mean, I like to ship Titans together? Like, I really want the Derby Titan and Santa Claus Titan to go out. That's a match we can have.
I feel like the best ship in Attack on Titan is probably Sasha X Potato.
Yeah.
That's like a match made in heaven.
I like Levi X Windex.
Yes! Yes! So good. So good.
And we're up at the back on your right.
Hi. Obviously, there's loads of different anime and you've been in lots of different ones, but if there was one not being you could be, what would you really be?
One anime? Or one show in general?
One anime, like, series in general. If there's one that's like, never been in your dream.
I grew up watching Dragon Ball Z, so I would love to be a part of that show in any way, and I know Dragon Ball Super is currently recording and coming out, so there may still be an opportunity. I'm just like, please hire me, I'd love to work on your show. So we'll see. But I was a huge Dragon Ball Z fan growing up. I was one of those kids who would watch Dragon Ball Z and then go to karate and try to go Super Saiyan. In the background.
If we were to do the same thing, with British and Irish actors, what would be your reaction? Would you favor it? No?
Like British or Irish actors doing dubs?
Yeah.
I think that that's awesome, personally. I think that any way people can express themselves and come to art, because I truly feel that cartoons and anime are an art form, and anybody that wants to be involved, I completely encourage. I don't think there's anything negative about it at all. That'd be like, oh, well, I'm American, so obviously I'm far more qualified to do this. I mean, America did invent the English language, right? So, Jesus. No, I know they didn't. I was kidding.
So, there are British dubs, actually. I'm working on a show right now, and I don't know if you guys have seen this. You probably haven't seen my version of the show. It's a children's show called Ruff Ruff, Tweet, and Dave.
Too far.
It's for little tiny kids.
Oh, no!
Like, let's say you would swap for, like,
can you are in your sort for someone else like that.
So I have to trade one of my characters for a character that someone else plays?
But that's where you're doing your name. You would swap your role for one of Trina's roles, but not from Attack on Titan.
Oh, I'm with it.
Sorry.
No, you're good, girl.
Actually,
get it.
So Trina usually has this sheet of characters, and it shows like all of the roles that she's done.
Yes, that one.
Yeah, and I was looking at her sheet as we were getting to know each other. I'm like, oh, let's see what Trina's done in the past. And there's a character on there that looks very similar to a character that I've played. And it turns out it's essentially the same character. So one of my first leads was in a show called Dot Hack Sign Legend of the Twilight Bracelet. And I play a character named Shugo. And he has this orange hat and kind of like, it's this kid going into a game. So
I play in Dot Hack Quantum a character named Safia, who has an orange hat and is a kid going into a game. And if you look at the character design of each of our characters, they're exactly the same, except mine has like little short shorts and pigtails, and his doesn't. So I guess those two characters would be swapped out easily.
Yeah.
Which is weird. Otherwise, I want to be a hamster.
I want to be a hamster.
I think that'd be dope. Also, I can, you know, fix my IMDb page with that other
one. We've got a fix for him.
It's too far.
Love it.
It's too far. Yeah.
How was it playing Bastion of Stampede in an earlier role for you guys? And Katrina, you play Yui in Speed Rapper and Rachel from Batman. I just wonder if it's kind of like the best of my group and how was your stay in the book?
I'm sorry, one more time.
How was your stay in the book?
Oh, yes. I did play Rachel and Bakano. I got one!
I didn't know you were in Bakano. I love that show.
Shut the front door!
So I was cast in a show called Rararam.
Yeah!
Which is in the same world as Bakano. So to kind of prepare myself to work on Rarara, I watched Bakano.
Yeah, I'm Rachel. I'm like the ninja girl with a cute little hat and short hair and I sneak around.
Awesome.
No big deal. I mean, you were in, you know, Cowboy Bebop, but I got it. They're great shows. Rachel Bakano and Yuri and Speed Grabber, who was like this girl that was amazing. It was awful. It's an awful, horrible story that I can't sugarcoat into a PG version. Those were great shows. And I loved Liverpool. I don't know what the first part of your question was. That was right. What was your first part of the question for Bryce?
Oh, I think I heard Vash the Stampede. Actually, I am Young Vash. Johnny Young Bosch plays Vash the Stampede grown up. I played Young Vash when I was about 14?
Are you serious?
Yeah, so I was Johnny as a kid, and now in New Exorcist we play brothers, and I'm the older brother. Just by a minute, but older brother.
How'd you like Liverpool?
And Liverpool has been amazing. Everyone has been super friendly. The city is so cool. I love the history here. I'm from California, so things that are old in California are like
get knocked down.
50 years old, maybe. Right. But like you see things that are hundreds of years old, and it's incredible to see.
It's really neat.
We got time for two questions here. We're going to leave it.
What?
There's two in the front.
The cow, man.
Hi. Okay. This is a question for Bryce.
Sure.
Me and my little sister, she's got a question to ask you as well. Both love Cat Noir from Miraculous Ladybug.
Awesome.
And I was wondering, what is your favorite line that Cat Noir says out of the whole show?
It's got to be a cheesy cat pun.
Yeah.
I mean, do you have a favorite line? Do you want to help me out?
I love it when he calls Ladybug Bugaboo. I really do love them together.
I love that relationship. I have no idea how they haven't figured out who each other are. They always miss it by like half a second. So
I'm gonna flash onto my little sister.
Awesome.
What's your favorite episode of Miraculous Ladybug?
That's a tough one too, because there's a lot of really good episodes. There's like a video game episode. I really enjoyed that one.
Thank you. Sorry, thank you.
There's the one with Evillustrator. I really love that episode. I think the character design of the bad guys. So every episode in Miraculous Ladybug, it's very similar to Sailor Moon. It's like someone is infected with something negative and they turn into the bad guy and Cat Noir and Ladybug have to stop them. So I really like the Evillustrator. He can draw things and kind of come to life.
Do you meow a lot?
It's more cat puns. Like his big attack that he does every episode is Cataclysm. Where he like makes a claw and he turns things dark and
I think it's really funny that in our life, we were talking about this, Bryce and I were talking about this earlier, like the strange situations we find ourselves in. But if we were, say, at a bar and I was like, do you meow a lot? You were like, I don't know. Like, I feel like there's more cat puns. There's some meowing. I guess it's a strange conversation. Random Thoughts by Trina.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in our master round of applause to our panelists today. Aww.